In a previous video, we looked at Stanford's Alpaca, which is a fine-tuning of the llama model. And they've got some great descriptions about how they made it, et cetera, in here. They also put up a nice place where you can try it out, which I talked about in the previous video. On top of all this, they've released a bunch of code for it. Because of this, there are a number of people sort of fine-tuning this now. I will make a video about fine-tuning it. But if you want to play around with it, here is a version of it that I've fine-tuned using the LoRa low-rank adaption stuff. So here's the Colab. You can basically just run it. It will actually do inference with a T4. So as long as you've got even a very low-level GPU, this should be enough for doing inference. So basically, this is making use of some weights that are on Hugging Face for the llama model. They've stayed up there, so this is why I'm comfortable actually releasing this now. I'm not sure why they haven't been taken down, but they've stayed up there. And because of that, we can fine tune this. I've done a fine tuning of this myself. And so this will basically load the original llama weights and then the LoRa fine tuning that I've done here. And you can then basically just open it up and run it and go through it. And you can see that the output of it is actually pretty good. Right. You can go back to the code to see the different instructions and stuff like that they use. So you can certainly play around with that. But you can see here, okay, we're asking it, what are alpacas and how are they different to llamas? So if we compare this to the original one, we can see that we're not getting exactly the same answer, but we're definitely getting something similar and we're getting something in the right range for these. And I found the answers that it gives or the text that it's generating is actually very, very impressive, to be honest. So here you can see another one where I've basically put write an ode to why alpacas make the best pet, and it's able to come up with some nice prose for this kind of thing. Another one I put in there was write an email to OpenAI saying why GPT should be open source. And you can see here, and all I've done is just copy this so that it's easier for us to read. So it comes up with, dear sir, madam, opening up GPT-4 to public access will allow researchers and developers from around the world to use it for their own projects in order to advance artificial intelligence. And it just keeps going. It's very coherent text, very on point. If you've got some good settings up here for the temperature, for the repetition penalty, etc., you'll find that it generates very nice coherent text. And you can play around with it. I found also that it can generate code pretty well for certain things, for simple Python functions and stuff like that. It can do a nice job. It comes up with some quite funny things. Here's one, write a convincing message about how alpacas are the real brains behind GPT-5. Although it may seem like humans have all of the intelligence, alpacas actually possess much more advanced cognitive abilities than we do. So it's very fun to play with and try it out. It can even do things like tell jokes. So you can have a look at it at the different sort of joke things. They're not always funny, but they come up with some interesting sort of jokes. And they're definitely in the format that you would expect for this kind of thing. Have a play with this. See, you know, how it goes. Any questions, as always, just put them in the comments and I'm happy to answer. In the next video, I'll walk through actually fine-tuning an alpaca model myself. Just another quick point before I finish up. If you wanted to play with the llama model, you could actually just change this text to do inference on the llama model. So you just would not load this last bit here, which is the fine tuning. And then you could access the llama model. You could use the same code for generating and for trying out that as well. All right. As always, if this was useful to you, please click and subscribe and let me know what videos you'd like to see in the future. Bye for now.